So is it too much to say that this is a real-world example of what can happen if you have a dysfunctional immigration policy?
That's absolutely right, Tucker. And I think you said it right, is that it's about that the immigration process in this country across the board is broke. This is a great example. American, you know, if they could look this up, the Flores decision. The Flores decision is what mandates the United States Border Patrol to release minor children. They only have a few amount of days, and once they hit that, they've got to release them, regardless if they've been properly vetted, regardless if they have a parent in the United States, they have to be released into the interior of the United States.
And so that's a judicial ruling. A court came up with that decision. Has Congress ever acted on it? I mean, since clearly that's crazy, why doesn't the United States Congress fix it?
That's a great question, Tucker. Another reason why I'm breaking my silence, because Congress could fix this in 5 minutes if they wanted to. Before I was the chief of Border Patrol, I was with the FBI, and I actually supervised an MS-13 gang force in Southern California. We used to catch them on surveillance wires, and they would laugh. MS-13 gang members would laugh how easy it was to go back and forth between the Mexico and U.S. border.
So we've had a number of debates on this show with Democrats who say there's something bigoted about criticizing MS-13. As someone who's actually worked to apprehend MS-13, how would you respond to that?
That's ridiculous. MS-13, and I know this may be controversial, but when the president referred to them as animals, I absolutely said that is correct.